22 mai. So I've started a new reading for you, Le Petit Prince 7, and you'll notice there's an asterisk here. I've given you that asterisk just to let you know it is purely optional. This is not graded or anything like that. I'm happy to keep checking up on your readings and following up with you and answering questions, but at this point it is all extra. It is the end of the semester. The only assignment you have is the oral submission that you have to do. All you have to do is just this reading. This reading is purely optional. So please focus on the submission, answering those questions about the Little Prince. And then if you have extra time or if you're really interested in continuing reading, please, by all means, okay? So I've set this reading up entirely in Classkick. And what I'll do is I'll send you an email with a link to the Classkick, and then I'm also going to give you this. And in the future, that's how I'll continue doing it, where I'll send everybody an email with a link to the Classkick, and I'll keep doing that into the summer. If you do not want to continue getting those emails, just let me know. That's fine. But I'll send it out to everybody so that you all have access to the reading. Even if you don't want to do it right away, at least then later you can finish the book on your own time if you like. I'll also include little discussion questions. And you know, we won't have Canvas, so you won't be able to discuss with other colleagues and stuff, with other classmates. So that's too bad. But these are meant to help kind of direct your reading, and I hope they help. Okay? So in French, it'll be dans cette lecture, le petit prince et le narrateur se disputent. Le petit prince accuse le narrateur d'être quoi? Ok, donc c'est une accusation et le narrateur est quoi? Qu'est-ce que le narrateur fait pour irriter le petit prince? Ok, déranger. Voilà. De, le narrateur apprend que le petit prince a une amie très importante. Qui est-ce? Hein, donc, qui est cette amie? Okay, and then in English, did you look up many words or just some? Maybe none. And then in this reading, we meet a very important character. How is this character different from the other ones we've met so far? So far we've met like the narrator, the little prince, kind of grown-ups, just generally. This one's different though. So again, this is entirely on your own initiative. If you're really interested in continuing this, that's awesome, and I'm happy to support you. If you want to respond to these questions in an email to me, that seems like the best way to do it. I don't have a plan yet for how to best continue discussions with a group outside of Canvas. But yeah. So on to the assignment, and this is the important part, right? So this is not optional. This is please do this. It's really important for your grade for the semester and for UW Green Bay and so on and so forth. So Le Petit Prince, enregistrement. So for this assignment, I'm asking you to submit a voice recording here in Canvas. In this voice recording, you'll answer in French several questions about your reading of The Petit Prince. And so you have until May 27th. So it's the 22nd right now, so hopefully you've already started this process of kind of thinking about how you want to respond. Maybe you'll submit the voice recording soon. Maybe you want to wait until May 27th. That's okay. It's up to you. But I really want to encourage you to start looking through these questions if you haven't already, and start kind of making notes, right? Notes of how you want to respond to them. Maybe think of what you absolutely must include, that like, okay, I don't want to forget to say this. And then maybe secondary things like, oh, if I have time, if I remember, I'll talk about this, right? So, décris le petit prince et utilise trois mots au minimum du vocabulaire du module 3. Hein? Trois mots au minimum. OK, and then ce roman présente l'idée que les enfants ont une vision plus exacte. Utilise les expressions du subjonctif et le subjonctif pour dire qu'est-ce qu'il faut faire. Qu'est-ce qu'il faut faire pour avoir cette perspective si précieuse, si importante. Okay. Et puis dans 3 à 10 phrases, fais un résumé du roman jusqu'à présent. Qu'est-ce qui s'est passé? And here I'd really like to see you use a few different tenses, right? So for the first one, my main goal is to get you to see how well you've understood the little prints and using the vocabulary for module three about values and friendship and such. For the second question, I really want to see you use the subjunctive in talking about this kind of central theme of the novel, right? Where the little prince represents kind of a worldview or an attitude about the world that has imagination front and center. And that goes against kind of what the adults traditionally do. So I'd like to see how you make sense of that in your own words using the subjunctive. And then finally, in this one, I really want to see you use a few different tenses. And you can just summarize, I suppose, what we've read. And I've given you some kind of sentence starters here to help you start formulating your response. So I think the first step would be to note a few things that you really have, feel like are good, part of the good answer. Maybe you could then sort those into like, okay, these are essential to the answer, these are kind of secondary. And then you can start building up sentences with these sentence starters. And this is how I'll be grading it. Again, I really want to keep grading really laid back. I do not want to make this a rigorous, intense assignment. I'm really trying to focus on, okay, please turn this in and you're good. But I do want to hold you to a certain standard of, okay, can you use this vocabulary? Can you use this subjunctive? Can you use these different tenses? And I think you can. You've demonstrated really, really well throughout the year that you're really capable of this stuff. So hopefully this assignment is just kind of a finishing, a kind of closure. And again, half of the grade is, okay, did you answer all three questions completely and in French? Okay, so really just, did you do the thing? And then I wanted to give some weight to clearly demonstrating your use of the grammar and then clearly speaking, right? Because it is a submission, an oral submission. And that's it. I'm really thinking about y'all. I am sad that the semester's coming to an end, but I also know it's a big relief. I definitely miss seeing y'all in class. And I plan on continuing, providing you the support through the readings. And also, as long as you'd like me to, I will continue doing the Wednesday afternoon YouTube live chats. I'm really grateful for those times to reconnect with y'all, to answer questions, and everything. So yeah. Until then, take good care and mardi.